In part two of the fermentation device comparison SMACKDOWN, we will take a closer look at the contestants, assemble each device, and begin to rate them on the pre-fermentation criteria. To recap, in part one, we discussed the parameters of the experiment and explained the review criteria we are using to score and rate the contestants.
Method number one, we'll use the old-fashioned jar and wait. We're just going to make sure that the jar submerges and pushes down so that the brine forms. I'm just going to take a tea towel and wrap it around so that it covers up, doesn't let flies in. And then I'm just going to take a rubber band and put it around the base of the jar. All right, old school method. Next, we'll use our newest kid on the block, mason tops. So I'm going to take one of these pickle pebbles, add it, push it down. In fact, I think I'm going to use a second one. They're meant to be stackable. Then I'm going to carefully lay the lid center on top of the jar. I'm just going to take a standard lid that came with a ring that came with it and add it on. And there's mason tops. Next up is fermenta cap. So we're going to take a jar, then we're going to take a pickle pebble, add it to the jar. We'll add a second pebble. And then I'm simply going to take fermenta cap and carefully screw it on top. Careful that there is a silicone gasket in there. Next up is AIRLOCK out of the UK. And this is the final of the waterless devices that we're testing. Put a pebble down. Remember, I made this ring myself and applied the gasket and the AIRLOCK cap. Place it down. Make sure to screw the ring on. And now we're moving on to our water-filled devices. First up is fermentin. Fermentin are the guys that also make these cool ceramic weights, so we're going to use that. Make sure it weighs down. And then I'm going to remove the two pieces, pull the two pieces apart, set the first one down, and take some filtered water and build a little moat here. There's a nice convenient fill line that you can see. I'm going to take the other top half and snap it into the first ring. I'm just going to take this and the standard ring, make sure to screw it on top. Next up is KRAUT. It's a clever device here. Push this in, apply the spring, and then I'm going to take the lid, apply it, and then gently pull this up and lock it in place. Then I'm going to fill the little moat. And finally apply the cap. And finally is our homemade beer AIRLOCK. So I'm going to take a few pickle pebbles, put them in. Again, this is just, you can get this at any brew supply shop. I just drilled a hole through a standard mason jar lid. And I'm going to apply the ring here. And the final step is to fill the AIRLOCK with water. And you kind of want that thing to float freely. We have all seven different devices and techniques. Add them all to the same container. It's a late winter here in Southern California, so this should be fine. I'm just going to keep it on the north side of the house so it stays out of direct sunlight.
After assembling the devices, we have our first pre-fermentation scores. Remember that it's on a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being poor and 5 being excellent. The first criterion is the profile. When fully assembled, can you put the device in a short shelf in your cupboard, or do you need to find an extra tall area to keep it? If the device has a taller profile, it's scored lower. If it was shorter or flush with the jar, it got a high score. Second was, how easy was it to set each device up? We included the build time of both the AIRLOCK and the three-piece AIRLOCK in our scoring. But of course, those are a one-time activity. When you use those in the future, you wouldn't have to build them again. The waterless devices generally did better because it took fewer steps to get them ready. With each of the water-based AIRLOCKs, we had to assemble a few pieces and then add water to the fill line. Here are the scores at the end of our first round. Coming up in the next part of the series, we measure the performance of each device over a 30-day fermentation period.